Good morning, my friends. Myself, Danish Sheikh, and today we will be speaking about voltage standing wave ratio. Voltage standing wave ratio is also called as V plus WR. What is a voltage standing wave ratio? Basically, just for an example, we can see a voltage standing wave ratio can be described as if I pass a wave from a tube with both sided open. If I pass a wave of sound or any other wave, it will travel in a sinusoidal wave. The moment it touches, it gets exits from the back. If I close this end, what will happen? This same wave will travel back to the source in the same direction, sorry, in the other direction with the same phase. So when this happens, if a wave travels back on the same path to the wave of its source, it appears to be standing. So, for an example, we can understand this is how voltage standing wave ratio looks like. But as the word ratio says, how can we mathematically describe V as WR? In a mathematical formula, V as WR, describe it as the ratio of maximum voltage to the ratio of minimum voltage in a transmission line. And this basic formula can also be given as 1 plus mod of tau to the 1 minus mod of tau. Imagine we have a transmission line which has a load on it and a current source. In this, if V is voltage is max, then obviously impedance would be minimum. And vice versa, if the voltage is minimum, then impedance would be maximum. As we found the Z minimum of the length at which impedance is maximum, we can similarly find the length at which impedance is minimum, that is Z is maximum. So the formula goes like minus 1 by 2 beta phi plus 2 m pi, where m is anything between 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on. This is the form of the formula from which we can find the length at which impedance is minimum. I guess this, my short video would have cleared some of the basic doubt about VSWR. Thank you very much for listening to my small lecture. Have a great day.